Hello, and welcome to our very first Plants vs. Zombies plush collection. So, let's get started. I'll be setting them right here. First, we are going to start off with the plants. And for our first plant, we're going to be showing the most iconic of them all, Pea Shooter. Now, this one is the redesigned Pea Shooter, like the newer release of it. As you can see, I've messed around with him a lot, so he's pretty flimsy. So we'll just set him right there. Another Pea Shooter, but yeah, this one sucks. Now we have Sunflower. Again, this is the redesigned Sunflower. I'll be setting him right there. Now we have the Chompers. Here is the Jazzwares Chomper. This is an official licensed plush. It is dated 2014, as you can see right there. And yeah, pretty good. You can open and close its mouth. Pretty neat. And I'll be setting him right here. Oh. I'll be setting him right here. And then we have the original release of the Lingsen Chomper. Well, this is the second design of the original release. The other two designs, the first and third, are pretty hard to find. This guy being the most common of them all. So, he has two eyes, he has a nose. I know what you guys are saying, oh, that's not Chomper. But for you people that don't know already, basically, this guy has these features because of some fan art. And yeah, even with this, I still like this plush a lot. It even has the purple string. So we'll be setting him right there. And I forgot to show you guys that I have two more sunflowers, both are officially licensed. This one is the Jazzwares Sunflower. I kept the tag on for whatever reason. It's a pretty nice plush. The petals are too long. It's the re-release one, so it doesn't have the little voice box inside that makes it sing. Even if it did, it would probably be broken at this point. So, I'll set it right there. And then we have the Titan World Max Sunflower. This is the big size. There are normal sizes. There is the keychain size and the just regular size. But ironically enough, they are harder to find than this one, even though this one is still kind of hard to find. So we should probably set it right in front of these dudes. Bye, Pea Shooters. And then we have the Snow Pea. This is the redesigned Snow Pea. It's pretty good looking for a redesigned plush. I'll set it, right here. That would be good. It's not as flimsy as the Pea Shooter because I got that one later than the Pea Shooter, which is behind this thing. All right, and then now we have what I like to call the Fume Squad. This is the smallest of the bunch. He is a, he would be a backpack clip fume shroom, but the backpack clip is missing on it. It's not that great of a plush. But I don't even know why I'm rambling over stuffy. Anyway, let me just set it right here. Very small compared to the others, especially that one. And then we have its bigger counterpart, which is, funnily enough, much worse, the redesigned Fume Shroom. Yeah, almost identical, but this one kind of looks angry. This one just looks plain sad, which it's not supposed to be. Plus, it's completely dark green when it's supposed to be white. Well, all the ones I have are green, but only the official licensed ones are white. And I don't have any yet, but I'm aiming to get some soon. Anyway, enough of that. Set them right there. And then we have the modern bootleg Fume Shroom. Yeah, he's a lighter green than the other two. It's a fine plush, I guess you could say. It's better than those two. We'll set it right there. And then last but not least, best for last, original release Fume Shroom with the Lynx and Tush tag and a purple string. Very good plush. We'll be setting it right here. Now, those are the only mushroom plushes that I have. Not only that, but also the only front yard night plant plushes that I have. Though I'm supposed to be getting the original release Doom Shroom pretty soon, which is pretty cool, and it's pretty rare. Forgot to mention this little Snow Pea backpack clip. And now we have a redesign three-peater. There was no actual original release. This was based off of a bootleg that was made earlier. So let's set him right there. And then we have two original release jalapenos. There's this one. I was acting dumb. I pulled on a loose string. The almost entire stem fell off. So I tried stitching it. And as you can see, my stitching sucks. Anyway, it's still pretty good. I'll set him right here. He has the red string as well. And for a better original release jalapeno, here you go. He doesn't have the red string. He has a white string. But he is in pretty good condition, better than that one. And he has a Lynx and Tush tag. So I'll set him right there. And then here is the Blover. This is the modern bootleg Blover. Normally it has dimples, but mine did not come with dimples for whatever reason. I'll set him right here. And then we have two star fruits. Here's the first one. Pretty cool. Has a little vine at the end. What's weird about the star fruit is that it doesn't have the little teeth that it would have, even though this is a modern bootleg plush and bootleggers are weird, so set him right there. And then here's the other star fruit. This is a big size star fruit. Here he is. Somewhat brighter than he is, but who cares, to be honest. It's a pretty good plush. Set him, crush these two jalapenos in honor of him. Here we go. And now we have the pulp plushes, so I will go over those pretty quickly. NKB Melon Pulp. Original release Melon Pulp. Original release Winter Melon. Another original release Melon Pulp with the Lynx and Tush tag. I can actually get it in view. Yep, there we go. Modern bootleg Melon Pulp. Modern bootleg Cabbage Pulp. And finally, redesign Winter Melon. And for our final five plush, redesigned Twin Sunflower, original release Twin Sunflower with the Lynx and Tush tag and yellow string, modern bootleg Cattail, this one's pretty weird, modern bootleg Bursa, this is the modern bootleg. I've been looking for the original release for a while now, and I've lost it three times, and as a surprise, I've finally gotten something. I've gotten the big size of it, so yeah, it's pretty cool. That'll be in the next collection video after season one of the series. And then finally, for the final plant, we have Laser Beam. This one's a rare one. And with that, we have our entire plant collection for now, because I'm getting a lot more coming. So all the plants are about to be gone, and it's about to be a bit more later because the zombies are coming in, and I'm going to be filming the next day. And now we start the zombie collection. First, we have the most iconic zombie. Basic zombie. Now this is the redesigned basic zombie. We're gonna be setting him right here. On top of that, here is a modern bootleg zombie. We'll set him beside. And then we have what I like to call the Cone Clan. First, we have Backpack Clip Conehead. We will be setting him right there. And then we have two redesigned Coneheads. One of them has a button shirt. Setting him right there. And then we have another that has its shirt unbuttoned. We'll be setting him right there. And then the best out of them all is my original release Conehead. We'll set him right here. And then we have the Buckethead zombie. This one is officially licensed and he looks pretty cool. Kind of the odd one out of the others. But yeah, he's pretty neat. I like him. We'll set him right here. And then we have the Pole Vaulter zombie. Well, mainly in my series I'm making, I'm going to be calling him the Runner Zombie, mainly because he doesn't have his pole. Then again, I could also craft a custom-made pole to attach to him, but hey, who knows. Anyway, pretty good plush. This is the re-release, so we'll be setting him right there. And then we have the promotional zombie head. This one's a hard to find guy. He's pretty rare, mainly because you can only really find him at, PAX East 2013. Yeah, pretty cool guy. I like him a lot, actually. He kind of looks like the Jazzwares zombie, which I do not have yet. I should be getting him soon, though. Anyway, I'll be sitting him right here. And then we have this strange purple zombie. I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be depicting when the zombie eats the hypno shroom and then it makes the zombie turn onto the other zombies. But in the series I'm making, it's supposed to be something wildly different. So I'll set him here. This is the original release as well. I do not have anything else but the original release. And then we have Dancing Zombie. I don't know why he has a guitar, but he does. And then I put this ring on him, which is pretty cool. Here's another Dancing Zombie that I don't know what I'm going to turn it into, but I'm turning it into something. So I'll sit him right here. By the way, these are not like the, you know, very rare ones that everyone talks about. These are just other ones that are, you know, newer releases and all. So, yeah, don't mistake them with that. I'm after the very rare Dancing Zombie. He should be in my hands sometime, but, you know, these aren't not them. These are not them at all. So, yeah, just take that in mind. I do not have all the very rare guys. So, enough of me rambling about that. Let's get on to the next zombie. And then we have two pole zombies. We have the duct tube zombie right here. This is the redesigned version of it. He's pretty cool. I'll be setting him right there. Duck makes him hard to sit around, so there. And then we have a pretty rare one, boys. We have the original release Dolphin Rider Zombie. He's not like, super rare. He'll appear every once in a while, but it takes a couple months at the very least for him to appear on eBay or Mercari or something. So I'll sit him right there, and that's all dandy. And then this is pretty out of place, but we have this right here. which many people call it Lobber, but I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be an imp. Looks nothing like an imp, though. We'll be sitting here right here. And then we have a couple random backpack clip zombies that I got off Amazon a while ago. We have the purple zombie. We have the rodeo zombie. We have basic zombie. We have duck tube zombie. We have witch zombie. We have swashbuckler zombie. We have pole vaulter zombie. We have grass skirt zombie, or as a lot of people like to call it, duckweed zombie. Then finally, we have base zombie. Base zombie. A lot of these guys I'm missing the normal size counterparts to, so if you find them and you don't really want to buy them, give me a holler and send me the link and I'll probably buy them and I'll thank you for them. So there's more coming, so let's get to that now. Now we have the original release Pompadour Zombie. This is the only original one that you could really get off Amazon, and they have a lot of stock of it, so if you want to get it, then get it off Amazon and don't wait for a used listing to pop up anywhere else. And then we have the Gargantuar Zombie. This is the modern bootleg Gargantuar Zombie. He looks kind of weird because he has like a red shirt instead of like a brown one. Doesn't have a collar. He does have a sack and an imp, but the sack I've been using for something else. So let me set him right there. And then here's the imp that goes with it. He has no legs because I'm pretty sure he wasn't intended to be taken out. I'm supposed to be getting the official version of both of these guys pretty soon. And then we have three more plush. We have the exploding zombie, which is the Red Fuse version. The Red Fuse version is... it's not easy, but it's not hard to find. So if you just keep looking for a little while, you will eventually find it. So yeah. Just keep checking if you want this guy, but not that it would really matter, because all that really matters is that he has a red fuse, and that doesn't really change much, except the rarity by a tad bit. Then we have this weird golf cover that wasn't originally intended to be Plants vs. Zombies related, but it looks a lot like it, so people are thinking that they made it something to do with it. And it was originally intended to be a golf cover, but I'm using it as like a, you know, sort of puppet or whatever. Set him here. And you might have been seeing this guy around just in the camera. This is my biggest plush right now. It is the big bootleg zombie. So I'll be sitting right there. He's not my rarest one, of course. My rarest one is about to be Big Bursa when he arrives. I'll show you guys that later on. Probably in like an episode of the series or whatever, but enough of my freaking rambling. This is all of the zombies. Pretty cool. Some of them I don't really like, some of them I do really like. It's all good. So, yeah. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, do all that random stuff if you want. I'm not forcing you to, I'm not begging you to. So, yeah, anyway, see you guys later.